Welcome to this week's WWE.com interview. I have a very special guest for the first time ever in this forum, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Brock Lesnar. Welcome. Brock, Sunday at Night of Champions on the WWE Network, one of the most anticipated rematches in the history of WWE, you versus John Cena. I want to start by going back to SummerSlam, the night you won the championship. It's been called the most dominating performance in the history of any main event in WWE. Did you expect your victory over John Cena to be that easy?
Well, I think we can go back farther than that, to my victory over The Undertaker. It's plain and simple for this, and I can keep saying, and it's like a broken record all the time, but I came back to this company for one reason and one reason only, and that was to be at the top, to be the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Everything that's been put in front of me, I think I've accomplished.
It's funny you mentioned The Undertaker, because when you took on The Undertaker at WrestleMania, you were the Hunter. When you took on John Cena at SummerSlam, you were the Hunter. This time around, this Sunday at Night of Champions, you're the Hunted. Does that change your strategy at all?
Not at all. I don't come into any fight with any other mindset than to just kick ass. That's all my job is. It's plain and simple. I got the best job in the world. Eat, sleep, kick ass, repeat. That's what I do. And I happen to enjoy it, and I'm happy to be very good at it. I'm not here to play off anybody else's emotions. I'm not here to play off of what other people think. Brock Lesnar is the face of this company. I don't know when people are actually going to get it through their head.
John Cena, I believe, still thinks that he is the face of WWE. And over the past number of weeks in SummerSlam, he has been trying to prove to the entire world and to himself that he can beat you and that he's ready for you at Night of Champions.
I'm not a man of many words, all right? That's why I have a guy that does all my talking for me. Now, John Cena, on the other hand, can talk all he wants to about what he's going to do. Kudos to John. Kudos to John Cena. He's been at the company for a long time. He's talked the talk and he's walked the walk, but he's finally faced a man that neither of them works. I don't really care what kind of John Cena shows up on Sunday. I really don't. It's not going to change my game plan at all. Not one bit.
Is your game plan going to change at all after what transpired on Raw this past Monday night? Cena wanted a fight. You gave him one. Cena was passionate. He was emotional. He seemed ready to go. Is this a different John Cena? Did you feel a different John Cena Monday night than you saw at SummerSlam?
I can't answer that. I'm not out there to feel another man's emotion. I mean, that's ridiculous. I come from a fight background. I come from an amateur background. Mano a mano, and the last thing I'm thinking about is another man's emotions. So no, I don't, like I said, on Sunday at Night of Champions, I don't care what John Cena shows up, whoever he is, whoever he wants to be at Night of Champions, I really don't care. I'm a prize fighter, all right? I come to Monday Night Raw to promote fights, all right? That's my job. I showed up on Monday night to promote Night of Champions. And it just so happens that John Cena is all fired up about this match on Sunday. And so am I. It's plain and simple. On Sunday, John Cena is going to get another ass beating.